This is Maria from MOP Reborns. It is really early on Sunday morning, and the reason why I'm speaking so low is because my children are sleeping. So I am going to do a quick video of Logan, whom I have been adding modeling layers to. And yesterday I did a modeling layer in blue. And so this was the blue that I applied to him, which was the same color I used for his veins. And so here he is, and he has that blue mottling and some very light veining that I did. And you can hardly see it, but it is there. And there you can see some of the veining and some of the mottling in that blue. So right now I'm going to apply another mottling layer, and this time it's going to be the yellow mottling. So I already have some of the yellow, it's very little, with some paint thinner. And I'm going to add just a little bit because I did let it sit here overnight, so it thickened up a little bit. And I don't want it to be that pronounced of a yellow mottling. Mottling will really add a lot of depth to your baby's skin. You know, when you look at human skin, our skin is not a flat color. It does have a lot of depth. So the mottling, it just helps it look more realistic. Okay, so here we go. We have our brush and our yellow. And now that I've thinned it out, I think I do need a tiny bit more of the yellow back. See, this is not a real science to this. It's more of something that you will want to play with until you get a feel for how something, especially paint, should look on the vinyl. And I've done this enough to know that I needed more yellow in there. But it's still translucent, it's still really thin. And so let's go ahead and apply that to our mottling sponge. And very important that you blot most of it out. As you can see, I still have all of the patterns here from the prior mottlings that I've done on this little guy. There was the strawberry pink and the blue from yesterday. Yesterday I had a really busy day. My daughter's had 20 things going during the day, so I was out a lot yesterday just trying to get them both from point A to point B and then to point C. So, and then we had to pick up a friend and then wait for another friend to show up. And I always want to make sure that even if it's not my kids, even if it's somebody else's kids, I want to make sure that they are where they need to be. So we were responsible for 5 kids yesterday, just making sure that everybody was where they needed to be. So here we go with the yellow mottling on Logan. And so this is a work in progress video for his mommy, Daisy. And I think the name of her channel is, she has a long name of the channel, 38 Flowers Love for Reborns, maybe. I'm sorry if I said it wrong, Daisy. There is that yellow mottling, and of course you can hardly see it, but it is there. So So let me put his head aside and start working on his arms. Okay, I don't have anything interesting to talk about this morning. It's really too early for me, but I'm up trying to get some of this done before we go to church this morning. And I hope you can see what I'm doing here. So as I press down on the vinyl, I rotate the sponge, and that prevents it from having a pattern, too much of a pattern that's too uniform. You want it to be random, so rotating the sponge will give you a random mottling look, and that's what you want. Okay, so here we go with the next piece. Lot, and this baby has really cute feet. He really does. And I hope I'm not going out of frame. And I will probably give this baby another layer of veining, because he's going to have a little bit of a more tanned skin tone. So those first veins I did may get lost in the mottling and darkening process. So always keep that in mind. You can always add, but once you bake, you can't take away. So when you do your veins, make sure that you do them light enough, and you can always go back and add more if you need to. And so with this baby, I am playing it by ear and just making sure that he gets all of the mottling layers he needs, and we'll go back and add more veining. I don't know if you can see, let me show you. He has a big vein going along right here. And then he has some, there's like three going from his wrist to the middle of the fingers. And then there's one right here. Oops, there's one right here. So it might be too light for you guys to see it. But even without my glasses, I can see them. So that's a good sign. I had, let me fix this. I had LASIK surgery 12 years ago. And I had really bad astigmatism, probably all my life, but I didn't know about it until my early 20s when I was at work and someone told me I was squinting at my computer. And until then, I didn't realize I was half blind. So I went to the eye doctor, and sure enough, I had really bad astigmatism. So I started wearing glasses, and in my early early 30s, after my second baby was born, I decided I wanted to try LASIK. And the procedure was not pleasant at all. So it was very uncomfortable. I am going to stop this video and start a new one, so I will see you all in a little bit. Okay, bye.